In this example, we use the heating curve of water to determine the energy needed to convert ice to steam. Our problem reads, how much heat is required to convert 50 grams ice at negative 15 degrees Celsius to steam at 119 degrees Celsius? The heat capacity of steam, water, and ice are 2.01, 4.18, and 2.09 joules per gram degree Celsius, respectively. The enthalpy of fusion and vaporization for H2O are 6.02 and 40.7 kilojoules per mole, respectively. We can start by drawing the heating curve of H2O. We're starting with ice at negative 15 degrees Celsius. Our first step is to increase the temperature of the ice to the melting point of ice, which is 0 degrees Celsius. As we add heat, the temperature of the ice increases according to its heat capacity. Once we reach our melting point, adding thermal energy no longer increases the temperature of the ice. Instead, the thermal energy goes into melting the ice by overcoming the intermolecular forces keeping the molecules in the crystal lattice of the solid. This is the melting process, and the temperature stays constant throughout it. After all the ice is melted, the added thermal energy goes into increasing the temperature of the water to its boiling point. The heat capacity of water will determine the energy needed for changing its temperature. Once the water reaches the boiling point, all the thermal energy goes into the vaporization process. During vaporization, the intermolecular forces keeping the liquid molecules close together are overcome, and the molecules escape into the gas phase. During vaporization, the temperature stays constant. Our last step is to increase the temperature of the steam to 119 degrees Celsius. The heat capacity of steam helps to determine the energy needed for this step. When we increase the temperature of a substance, we can use the equation heat equals mass times the specific heat capacity times the change in temperature to calculate the energy needed. We're starting with 50 grams of ice. The specific heat capacity of ice is 2.09 joules per gram degree Celsius, and the change in temperature is T final minus T initial, or 0 degrees Celsius minus negative 15 degrees Celsius. Completing the calculation, we should get 1,568 joules to increase the temperature of the ice from negative 15 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. Next, we need to melt the ice. We're given the enthalpy of fusion, and fusion is changing from a solid to a liquid. So we can use dimensional analysis to convert our mass of ice to the energy needed to melt ice. We'll start our dimensional analysis with 50 grams of H2O. We can convert from grams to moles using the molar mass. And we can use the enthalpy of fusion to convert from moles of H2O to kilojoules of energy. Completing the calculation, we get 16.71 kilojoules. Our third step is to increase the temperature of the water from 0 degrees Celsius, the melting point, to 100 degrees Celsius, the boiling point. We can use our equation, heat equals mass times specific heat capacity times change in temperature. We still have 50 grams of water. Melting the ice didn't change the mass. The specific heat capacity of water is 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius. And T final minus T initial is 100 minus 0 degrees Celsius. Completing the calculation, we get 20,900 joules. Our fourth step is to vaporize the water. We're given the enthalpy of vaporization in the problem. We'll use dimensional analysis again, starting with 50 grams of H2O. We can convert to moles using the molar mass of H2O, and we can convert to kilojoules using the enthalpy of vaporization. Completing the calculation, we get 112.96 kilojoules. Our fifth step in the heating curve is to increase the temperature of the steam from the boiling point, 100 degrees Celsius, to 119 degrees Celsius. When changing temperature, we use heat equals mass times specific heat capacity times the change in temperature. We need to use the correct specific heat capacity for steam, and our change in temperature is 119 degrees Celsius minus 100 degrees Celsius. Completing the calculation, we should get 1,910 joules. The last thing we need to do is sum the energy for our five steps. We need to make sure we use the same units of energy for every step. We'll convert to kilojoules. So 1,568 joules for the first step becomes 1.568 kilojoules. We do the same conversion for our other steps, where we change temperature, and completing the addition, we should get 154 kilojoules.